All right, and it looks like it fired off. And what do we have here? We have Relic of Progenitus, a tower, two plants, and an ancient stirring. So I need a green source for the ancient stirrings. And I have a cycle here as well. I'm going to keep this hand, but I'm not in love with it. Start out with the relic here. And I'm probably just going to pop off this relic right away. The thing is, we're not going to be missing any land drops, but you know, we really want to obviously get the Tron as soon as possible. Yeah, that Grove was actually a pretty good draw, but I'm going to do this. Mostly because if I draw a Chromatic Star, I want to play it this turn. Alright, that was also good. Anyways, I'm still going to play my tower here because there's a chance that I'm going to just draw Urza's Mine. If we do, then I can just play Wormcoil Angel. Playing against some kind of Esper control deck, it looks like. Let's go Chromatic Star. And that green mana. I don't know if I want to cast Sylvan Scrying right now. Because if it gets countered, it's not great for us. Eh. Yeah, I mean, that Spell Snare is going to get that Sylvan Scrying every single time. Like, I want to cast that turn, because on the following turn, I want to play my Ancient Stirrings. Alright, so that got remanded. Our opponent is light on mana, so this is pretty good for us. Generally, these matchups are pretty good, assuming this is some kind of a control deck. Tron just kind of has inevitability, because you're just going to have more mana to work with than the opponent. Path to Exile, although Pyroclasm is a less than ideal draw. Alright, so you know what? I'm going to play Urza's power plant this turn, just so I don't get mana leaked. If it gets spell snared, I mean, you know, it gets spell snared, but I just did not want to get mana leaked there. Because I can just play a bunch of stuff next turn. Alright, there's a land. Let's play an expedition map. There's just so many things that you actually have to counter. It's actually very, very difficult to keep this deck off Tron, I found. Well, I guess a hard counter will do. This is some kind of Esper Dragon deck. We find a mine here. You know, I actually think I want... Oh, no, I don't want to get spell snared again. This is kind of unfortunate. I wanted just to find, like, a land, but I guess I'll... You know what? I'm going to get a Chromatic Star. So the reason why is because I want to get Tron as soon as possible. And... I want to get Tron as soon as possible. And we're gonna have like a lot of gas with just the having the Iavugan in play. And I do not want to play the Iavugan right now, because our opponent could have something like a Ghost Quarter, so I'll play it when I have to. Esper Charm, draw two cards. All right. I guess we're just gonna play Wurmcoil Engine. Tron has done a pretty good job of keeping us off of our Tron. Draw two cards. If our opponent made us discard, it would have actually been pretty bad for us. Discard. If you had a Path to Exile, I probably wanted to just cast it. Discard Silumgar Scorn? Jeez. Yeah, I think that was just throwing away a counterspell. Because sure, now you get the Path to Exile me. I mean, I guess, yeah, I guess if the best time to do it is on my draw step. Go ahead and get our forest. That's why it's in there. Then we have an Iavugan here. Keep getting Wurmcoil Engine. Actually, no, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. You don't need to get a Wurmcoil Engine. If our opponent cannot kill Iavugan, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, yeah. We can just get Ulamog. Or as a lot of people call him, Nulamog. Dragonlord Ojutai. All right. Tron piece? No. You know what's fun? It's actually interesting. It's like it might actually be correct. It might be correct to just play an Oblivion Stone here and kill the Ojutai. Because if I play the Ulamog and get two lands, then it gets Path to Exiled. Then if our opponent has a Silumgar Scorn, we'll kind of die. All right. I'm gonna try this line. But I'm not 100% that it's the correct line. Because I think with five lands, like. Mean, I don't know how many Dragonlord Ojutais are in the deck. Now our opponent can choose the Cryptic Command and bounce the Dragonlord Ojutai. But if our opponent does that, that's just like a huge tempo swing because Dragonlord Ojutai won't even be on the board. Right, so needed the land here, I guess. If our opponent goes land into another Dragonlord Ojutai, that's a little trickier, but so yeah, I'm likely running this into a counter, but I just want to get two lands. Destroy two target lands. Not bad. Not bad. So our opponent has one path to exile left, which is good for us. I mean, if you have a Cryptic Command, you're going to Cryptic Command this. All right, so we did get Cryptic Commanded. All right. Cycle this. That was really good. I'm not gonna lie. Our opponent could have another Cryptic Command or Silumgar Scorn. I guess this is the situation where I'd want the other Ulamog, but... Remand. I suppose looking for a Silumgar Scorn? And Dragon Lord Silumgar. All right. Had to have the Silumgar Scorn. So it's got Remand and Silumgar Scorn. Jeez. Discarded one, too. We actually can't Iabugin now. Perhaps I should have just waited until the next turn. Yeah, maybe that was better. My thought process was if our opponent doesn't have a counter for the map there, they just lose on the spot. Because I fetch the mine, and then I can use the mana to search for an Emrakul and get there. But what I probably could have done is search for the Emrakul end of turn or on our opponent's end of turn, still play the map, and I think I still would have had mana. Yeah, 3-6. I still would have had mana to play the Emrakul. So I believe that was a small misstep in sequencing. Opponent found land. 5, 6, 7. Wow. You would think that 25 cards in, we'd find one copy of this card. All right. Well, the grind begins. We're not quite at Emrakul mana. Oh, Esper Charm? Sure. Let me think. Let me see if I can play around Remand. So if I go Forest here, 3, 6, 7, if I do tap these two. If I tap these two, I can search for the mine, play the mine. Then I'll have 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 mana. This is actually fine then. Don't have the spell snare. Come on. Oh, yes. All right. Now, here's another interesting question. Can I do it next turn? Can I search 3, 6, 7? I'll have 1, 2, 3. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. I can, okay. So I can actually play Emrakul next turn. So 3, 5, 7. Search. I'm just gonna get a Wurmcoil Engine this time. The inevitability. Yeah, next turn we still have the mana. 2, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. We have exactly enough mana to search for Emrakul and then cast it. And who knows? It's possible this Wurmcoil engine can get it done too, because our opponent's already cast three Path to Exiles, and I use the Relic. I don't know if this deck plays Snapcaster Mage. We haven't seen any yet. Right. Emrakul. We have any other threats left in our deck? Wurmcoil. I don't think so. Let's see, what can we get here? I get an Urza's Tower and our opponent kills our Emrakul, can we still just go off? 3, 6. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 3, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. All right. Yeah, because in that case, what I can do here is just attack with the Emrakul. Our opponent has to block. Most likely just going to Cryptic Command. Oh! Sure. Wait, that doesn't exactly work. Our opponent now has to kill this Spellskite. If our opponent goes Dragon Lord Silumgar plus Path to Exile, it works. We might as well just go for it, I guess. Boo. It was a good try. It was kind of cool. I'm actually impressed by just kind of how our opponent managed to like still navigate around all of this. All right, sideboard time. Pyroclasm's bad. I think Oblivion Stones are actually okay. Let's see. I'm trying to figure out what that deck could potentially board in. Boils, good. And I actually saw no graveyard. I saw no Snapcaster Mages or anything like that, so I think I don't necessarily need the Relic of Progenitus here. Yeah, Thragtusk I think is just like a good annoying threat for them to deal with. Just kind of want to maximize on threats here. What What else would they have? Like, would they have land destruction? Would I consider Crucible of Worlds? Like, I didn't see anything. And it looked like black was a light splash for Dragonlord Silumgar. So, you know, I didn't see like a Tectonic Edge or anything like that. So I don't know that they have it. I don't know if I want Crucibles. I might want some Rending Volleys for Dragonlord Ojutai. But at the same time, I might want some stuff. Like, they have to have cards like Stony Silence. So I do want to have some number of routes. So I think maybe like 3 Nature's Claim comes in. Maybe like 2 Rending Volleys. And then I can look to like cut some of these cards. And probably shave on a Wurmcoil Engine. Thragtusk is actually better than Wurmcoil Engine, because even if they path to exile it, you still get a 3/3 token. Is Ugin bad? It's kind of expensive, but... I don't need all the Oblivion Stones. Actually, Oblivion Stones don't seem good at all. I'll just do that and bring in another Rending Volley, maybe? The problem is it doesn't get Dragonlord Silumgar. Alright, I'll keep 1-0 Stone in, just because. But... the sideboarding was a little loosey-goosey, but we have answers to a little bit of everything while keeping kind of the core of the deck intact. And I'll keep. And whenever you have two different Tron lands in your opening hand, and I do have the Chromatic Sphere, I feel like I need to keep. Our opponent could go turn to Stony Silence, which would be bad. Oh, yeah. I mean, one day in the life of a Cheon, right? Is that what people would say? I don't know. Lucky, lucky, lucky. I'm not gonna sack this. Just yet. There's no reason to. If our opponent plays a Stony Silence or something, I can just... Also, if I draw like a Boil, I might need the colored source. I guess this is as good a turn as any. Just run out the Karn. It could get Silumgar Scorn, but I mean, there's a decent chance our opponent has Dragon. So, like, there's no, I don't see a huge reason to play around Silumgar Scorn there. Nine. Cryptic Command. I just, you know, like, our opponent's gonna have some counter magic. I want to be able to fight through some of it. Alright. Once again, I want to keep my Chromatic Star or Chromatic Sphere. I guess this is a good time to crack this for green. All right, fair. I was going to say, I don't think that gets countered. All right. Three, four, five, six, seven. I think it's more important to resolve this Sylvan Scrying than like try to cast an Ugin, I think. And here, let's just play the plant. Discard two cards. All right. Okay, well. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. That'd make it one cheaper. I could play an Ulamog just to get two lands out of our opponent's hand. Or two lands off the board. It's likely going to get countered. And the next turn I can... It's either that or... like, because the thing is, if I had the mana to cast an Emrakul next turn, I'd probably just go for that instead. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. So, yeah. I think I'm going to go for the Nulamog. Actually, maybe I should target Glacial Fortress because we have Boil. Doesn't look like this deck has Snapcaster Mage. Oh, pick it up. It's unfortunate that we drew the forest. Because now if it gets Path to Exiled, we do not get a land. Oh, hey, it's the... Oh, okay, well, they do have Snapcaster Mage. Fair enough. That seems like a fairly... You don't want to counter the... Okay, I guess you have Path to Exile. Oh, Path to Exiling these... Oh! I see. You have a Drangler Silumgar? And you need a land? Pretty cool. Boom. Let's see, did we get the basic swamp? We did. So I see what my opponent is trying to do here. And, this is going to be pretty good, I think. Reeling Dragonlord Slumgar. Man. I was trying to do something cool, man. Come on. Alright. God. I was gonna get a ghost quarter and ghost quarter the watery grave. We don't have any spell skites in our deck, unfortunately. All right, we need to draw an Urza land. Actually, let me think about this. If I just get a Wyrmcoil engine, can our opponent even afford to attack? With Emrakul, we have to get lucky. With Wyrmcoil engine, our opponent attacks us. We have 40 cards in our deck. Yeah. Okay. The thing is, this prevents an attack from the Ulamog. Oh man, come on. Actually, this is good. I don't think our opponent wanted to. Well, actually, I mean, I blocked here so I can get two tokens. And I think our opponent drew like Snapcaster Mage. That's the only thing that makes sense to me. Unless it was a path to exile, but if it was a path to exile, our opponent should have just cast it anyways. So I'm trying to figure out what combination of cards our opponent could have had there. But I think gaining the life there is also reasonable. It buys me some time. Although I guess we do die to one more activation of the Ulamog. GG's, nice to play. Wait, that was just. Oh. Okay. I was very surprised that I actually won there after the Dragon Lord Silumgar. Oh, but we were on top deck Karn and Lucky Cheon. All right.